Hey everyone, it's 2020, a new year. And despite it being the roaring 20s again, apparently a lot of people have a new year's resolution to stop drinking for January. But it seems that the whole country of Australia have massively misunderstood what the term dry January means, as a tinderbox of undergrowth has contributed to some of the worst wildfires in recent history. Looking over the headline claims, there's death, hundreds of millions of dollars of damage, vast clouds of smoke visible from space, and scenes resembling something out of Mad Max. Certainly this was probably not what people were expecting last year at Edgbaston, when the Australians gloated about how Australia would retain the ashes in 2020. But of course, the real crux of the story inevitably turns to whether the tragedy was man-made or not. And I saw someone on the internet commenting that if that's how hot and arid the weather is in January, imagine how bad it would be in the summer. Completely ignoring, of course, the fact that this is the summer in the Southern Hemisphere. Probably one of the good things actually about this particular disaster is that it's probably about a month's journey by sea to get to Australia, so it's unlikely we'll have to see Greta Thunberg sailing out there, although if she did, she'd need a bigger bucket, but you can get them cheap in the January sales, I guess. Nonetheless, I think it's important to add that this fire was very much man-made. 100 years ago, people used to actively manage that forest. The Aboriginal people recognised that you need to start small fires occasionally to burn away the undergrowth, otherwise you create a nationwide tinderbox that burns faster and fiercer than that chicken fowl that my old curry house in Durham used to make. A dish that ironically was best put out with a pint of Foster's or Castlemaine 4X. What we do know for sure though is that there's a lot more urban development stuff to burn down than the last time Australia had a fire like this, and thus the damage in terms of dollars will be higher by definition because there's more nowadays to physically destroy, and it's nothing to do with climate change. Probably the saddest part in this story is that if a huge rainstorm were to gather and douse the flames in the next couple of days, it would probably be declared unusual, perhaps unseasonal, and get the climate protesters more excited than that time that failed presidential candidate Al Gore decided to go on tour promoting a conspiracy theory that actually had nothing to do with Russia for once. Lesson for you there, Hillary. Anyway, see you next week. If you like these, click subscribe.